Are we ready now? Daniel chapter 10, verse 13. Can you pick your Bible? Stand. Let's read the word of God to put the devil to shame. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief priests, came to help me, and I remained there with the kings of Persia. Let's read it one more time. One, two, go. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief priests, came to help me, and I remained there with the kings of Persia. May the Lord bless the reading of the word. Sit down on your enemy's head. And for those of you that are standing, stand on your enemy's head. Somebody shout fire. I want to share with us on what I titled Silencing Enemies of Your Miracle. Tell your neighbor, silencing enemies of your miracle. Please make sure you are vocal. If you are not vocal, you will die local. Tell your neighbor, silencing enemies of your miracle. Your mouth is your amount. So is it the gateway to your destiny? When men sit, you will stand. When men stand, you will outstand them. When men try to outstand you, you will outshine them. What is miracle? Miracle is a supernatural event that disobeyed the natural law. Miracle is a supernatural event that disobeyed the natural law. What is miracle? It is violating scientific and philosophic laws. You did not hear me. The scientific laws says that HIV cannot be healed. When HIV is healed, that is miracle. Am I talking to somebody here? What is miracle? When doctors say you are going to die of cancer that is hopeless, and God heal you, that is called miracle. Today, I see creative miracles here. Am I talking to somebody here? Miracle is a supernatural event that scholars cannot explain, factorize, analyze, expatiate, am I define. It is beyond academic modules. It bypass your medulla, cerebrum, and oblongata. Am I talking to somebody here? Somebody is about to receive that kind of miracle. Am I talking to somebody here? If you are there, shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. I see somebody here entering a new level here. Whatever door that have been closed against your life is about to be opened. Am I talking to somebody here? What is miracle? What you cannot do, what I cannot do, but God can do, and we can see. Did you hear me? What is miracle? What you cannot do, what I cannot do, but God can.
and we can see.
Can I talk to somebody here? Miracle is an instantaneous manifestation of God's grace on earth. What is miracle? It is when divinity visits humanity. When divinity visits humanity is a miracle. I prophesy, somebody here is receiving that miracle. Shout that amen like thunder. Shout it like thunder. Hear this. Daniel prayed for 21 days and God heard him. Can I say this? All prayer are heard by God. When I hear somebody say, God has not heard my prayer. No. God hears all prayer. The question is that the answer can be yes or no. Am I talking? So, when your prayer is not answered, it does not mean God did not hear it. He said, my ears are not too blocked that I cannot hear your cry. My hands are not too short that I cannot touch you. And my legs not too short that I cannot move through and fro. The answer of God is stronger and longer than the longest thing you can ever see. Am I talking to somebody here? I don't know where they have locked you. For 21 days, Daniel prayed, but there was an enemy of miracle. And the enemy of the miracle is called Prince of Persia. Am I talking to somebody here? Who is Daniel? Daniel was a man of God. Who is Daniel? Daniel was a prophet. So, is it possible for answer of a miracle of a man of God to be released, and a demon and Prince of Persia can with all the prayer and the answers? Yes, there are some of you, the answers to your problem has been settled since last year, but there is a prince holding the answer, holding the miracle. Today I came here like a fire brigade to remove them. I remove them. Wherever they have held your miracle, every enemy of your miracle, anyone that say you will not go to that position, anyone that say, when I say it, you say fire. Anyone that say you will not enter that position, fire. Anyone that say you will not marry, anyone that say you will not build that house, fire. Anyone that say you will not enter the next level,
fire.
Anyone that say you are not going to change level,
fire.
Anyone that say there will be no extravagant glory,
fire.
Anyone that say you will not change level,
fire.
Anyone that say you cannot be healed,
fire.
Every enemy of your miracle,
fire.
Every enemy of your ministry,
fire.
Every enemy of your marriage,
fire.
Every enemy in your political position,
fire.
Any enemy assigned to your life,
fire.
Wherever they are,
fire.
Let them die by fire,
fire.
Die by fire,
fire.
Die by fire. Shut fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire!
Hey!
Hey!
Shut fire!
Fire!
Am I talking to somebody here? Can I talk to somebody here? All of you have a miracle. But there is somebody that is sitting down and say you must not get it. You don't get me.
They want to give you that contract. Somebody just went there to that office and said, why should you give him that contract? That is enemy of your miracle. You are not getting me. A man came and said, I want to marry you. Then another Jezebel said, do you want to marry that girl? That is enemy of your miracle. Your church is growing. All of a sudden, somebody is saying, are you going to that church? That is enemy of your miracle. They want to give you a political position. Somebody just came up from nowhere and say he's not qualified, he's not loyal. That is enemy of your miracle. Am I talking to somebody here who has gone to Winch Coven to go and withhold my answer? Who has gone to Winch Coven to go and withhold my miracle? Because the miracle had been released. God appeared to Daniel and said, Daniel, and through the angel, he said, for about 21 days, you have been praying. I have already answered you since day one. Some of you, what brought you here? For since last year, God has answered you, but somebody has kidnapped your miracle. They will let it go today. I said they will let it go today. I said that we'll let it go today. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Somebody shot fire. Somebody shot fire. Hear this. In 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. Can you help me at the table? 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. Talking, he said, this charge I commit unto you, Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare. So when you receive prophecy, you don't sit down. He said, this prophecy that we're giving to you, Timothy, I want you to war. I want you to fight. It is not enough to receive prophecy. You have to fight for the performance, for the manifestation, actualization, realization, the practical push of the prophecy. Every of your prophecy that is in the spirit realm, I bring them to the physical. I did not like the amen the way you are shouting it. Shout it like thunder. Shout it like thunder. Did they say you are going to have a child and you don't have a child? Today, I release your baby. As God said you will enter that position and they say you will never enter, today, I release you for that position. As God said, you will go to the next level, and they said you will never go. Today, I release you to that next level. If the amen is louder, a breakthrough is coming. Shout the amen well. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 3. He said, if the cloud be full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth. And if the tree fall towards the south or towards the north, in the place where the tree fallen, there it shall be. What does that mean? He said, the cloud is already pregnant with rain. He said, when the rain is in the cloud, where will it empty itself? On the ground. Where is the ground? You are the ground. The heaven is pregnant with your glory. Today, I empty it to you right now. May your life container receive your breakthrough. I say, may your life container receive your breakthrough. The cloud cannot gather for nothing. Whenever the cloud is gathered, it means the rain want to fall. Ladies and gentlemen, your cloud has gathered, your rain must fall. I say, your cloud has gathered, your rain must fall. The rain, the cloud cannot gather for nothing. When the cloud gather, the rain must fall. I prophesy, receive your rain. 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 If you are not a wind, shout fire. Power this mic for me. Shout fire. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. I prophesy, the cloud cannot gather for nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, your cloud has gathered. Your rain must fall. Your cloud has gathered. Your rain must fall. Your miracle must manifest. Shout that amen like thunder.
Sit down. Am I talking to somebody here? I didn't hear. I said, am I talking to somebody here? You might not like my face. That is your opinion. Somebody say, I don't like you. Everybody cannot like you. If God loves me and you love me, who then can be against me? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Say, neighbor. Minus my enemy plus God. Something must happen in 2020, in 2016. Can I say this? There are some people you should not beg. Anyone who does not want you to go to the next level is your next devil. You did not hear me well. Anyone that does not want you to go to your next level is your next devil. Every devil of your next level, I kill them. Hey! 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 Somebody say, Aurora! Say, Aurora! Put your hands on your head, say, Aurora! Say, Aurora! Say, Aurora! Say, Aurora! In the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 12, he said, right from the days of John the Baptist, my kingdom suffered violence. The violent men shall take it by force. I take my miracle by force. I take my job by force. I take my baby by force. I take my ministry by force. I move to the next level by force. I overtake by force. You cannot kill me. I enter by force. My children graduate by force. I enter financial breakthrough by force. You cannot kill a man that God has lifted up. Somebody said, fire! Enter the next level by force. Enter it by force. Shot fire. Shot fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. I prophesy, enough is enough. Wherever they have covered your glory, wherever they have covered your mercy, wherever they have covered your lifting, today I put an end. I put an end. I put an end. Who is holding my rain? Anyone holding your rain from falling, today I kill them. I kill them. If the amen is louder, somebody is getting the miracle. Hear what the Bible says. In 1 Kings chapter 1 verse 13, the mother of Solomon said to Bathsheba, said to Solomon, 1 Kings chapter 1 verse 13, go and get thee into the kings, David. Say unto him, did not thou, my lord, O king, swear unto thy handmaid, saying, assuredly Solomon's son shall reign after me, and he shall sit on my throne. Why then doth Adonijah reign? Do you know what happened here? Adonijah was already a king, sitting in the position, and David was alive. And the mother
and the mother of Solomon cried out and said, David. He called David. He called the prophet and said, go and meet David. Tell him he promised me as shortly that as long as I am the king of Israel, when I'm about to leave, I will handle Solomon to be a king. Solomon was not a legitimate order of marital order. But because grace for miracle was at work, God changed the program. If a sitting king can be removed because of Solomon, who is sitting on your throne? Who is sitting on your position? Who is sitting in your miracle? Who is sitting in your place of blessing? Today, I remove Adonijah. Every Adonijah around your life, I remove them. I prophesy, occupy your throne. Occupy your throne. Occupy your throne. Enough is enough. They will let you shine in your place of glory. Somebody shout fire. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Shout fire. Shout fire. Am I talking to somebody here? In Joshua chapter 14, verse 12, a man called Caleb, after 40 years, God spoke and gave a prophecy in Joshua chapter 14, verse 12. Then he began to say, therefore, give me this mountain, wherefore the Lord spake in that day that thou heardest, in that day that how the Anakims were there, that the cities were great and the fence. If so be, Lord will be with me, then I shall be able to drive them out. I prophesy. Mountain talks about an high place. And this man began to speak that the Lord told me after 45 years. By this time, this guy was 85. Then he said, the Lord told me that this mountain will be given to me. He spoke with Joshua. I prophesy. Every position, every blessing that the Lord has spoken to you, that the enemy took away, occupy it. That amen is looking for my trouble. That amen is looking for my trouble. Shout that amen like thunder. Anyone sitting on your position, anyone that have delayed and stagnated your life, today I remove them. I say I remove them. I remove them. If the amen is louder, a breakthrough is coming. Every anarchy possessing your land, saying that you will not enter the land, today I remove your anarchies. I remove your anarchies. I remove your anarchies. I remove your anarchies. If the amen can be louder, somebody, you are getting a miracle. In Esther chapter 6, verse 1, the Bible says, and of that day, the king could not sleep. The king could not sleep because of Mordecai. On that night, could not the king sleep. And he commanded to bring the books of record of the chronicles. And they were read before him. And he said, what honor had been done to the man who defended the former king? And of that day, tonight, anyone holding your miracle will not be able to sleep. I said they will not be able to sleep. Anyone holding your success, they will not be able to sleep. Wherever they are, they will not be able to sleep. Anyone holding your glory, they will not be able to sleep. Shout that amen like thunder. Hear this. The man that that is supposed to marry you, that have refused to marry you, from tonight, he will not be able to sleep. The man that is supposed to sign that contract, that refused to sign that contract, from tonight, will not be able to sleep. The man that is supposed to sign your position to the next office, from tonight, will not be able to sleep. Am I talking here? Any member that is supposed to lift you to the next level as a pastor that have refused to lift you, from tonight will not be able to sleep. I prophesy. The Bible said in the book of Esther 6:1, and of that night the king was not able to sleep, and he said, bring me the books of record. Where are the records? Where have they recorded your miracles that have been stagnated? Today, books are open. You are remembered. You are remembered. You are remembered. You are remembered. If the amen is louder, somebody is living here a testimonial. Shout that amen like thunder. Matthew chapter 6 verse 10. He said in his word, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Thy kingdom come. Thy will. Thy will. Thy kingdom come. Today, your kingdom has come. Am I talking to kings and queens here? Am I talking to kings and queens here? I am looking for them all around. Where are the kings? Where are the queens? I prophesy, your kingdom has come. Hear this. Hey, our Lord's Prayer is a prophetic formula for believers' direction.
Yes.
Hear
yes.
This.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
I lived in a one-room apartment for more than 7 years. So very amoebic. I don't know what my landlord had in a heart, whether he wanted to build a goat house and decide to turn it to a human being house. I could not pay a house rent that was less than $50. I couldn't pay. I suffered. In fact, when I dress and I'm preaching, my members will be laughing. One day I call two of the sisters. I say, why are you laughing? Am I saying funny thing that you are laughing? I said, I'm talking about hellfire and heaven and you are laughing. You are supposed to be thinking about where you spend your eternity. They say, Papa, whenever we see your dress, we used to laugh. Because my trouser was not long trouser, it was short trouser. You don't understand. When a trouser is supposed to be long and it looks like a short and it's not short, so we call it short trouser. Can I preach here? Can I preach here? Can I preach here? When your kingdom has not come, you become an object of ridicule. When thy kingdom has not come, your last born in your family will insult you as a firstborn. When your kingdom has not come, people that are not qualified to talk to you will insult you. When your kingdom has not come, people that you have helped because they have gotten to a position, they will treat you and mesmerize you. When your kingdom has not come, you can be beautiful, you catch walk, but when men see you, they see you gorilla walk. You are catch walking, but they are not seeing you catch walking. They are seeing you gorilla walking. when your kingdom has not come. Oh my God. Are you getting what I'm saying? You walk like elephant and you reap like ant. When thy kingdom has not come, you gather members and beg them to come to church. They will not come to church. When your kingdom has not come, when people gossip you and criticize you, you are moved. But hear this. When you get to the top, you become a topic. And topic is topic. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? If I am driving bicycle, you talk about me, I can have headache. If I am driving a bike, you talk about me, I can have headache. If I am in a vehicle, you talk about me, I can have less headache. But if I am cruising in a private jet, you talk about me, I will laugh at you. Your time has come. Somebody shout fire. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Shout fire. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. The day. Several years ago. Look. I was very poor. That even people I know that they are poor, they were calling me poor. You are not getting me. People that I myself know they are poor, they now meet me and say, yeah, sorry. Sorry for your poverty. That was poverty have level. I don't know the level where you are, but today I remove you from it. Holiness is not the absence of prosperity. Holiness without prosperity is spiritual stupidity. Holiness without prosperity is spiritual stupidity. Part of the package of holiness inculcated, inserted, is purity, prosperity. I wish above all things that you may prosper, be in good health, even as thy soul prospered. Tripartal prosperity. Prosperity of your soul, holiness. Prosperity of your head, divine in it. Prosperity of your pocket. Prosperity all over. I prophesy, your door open for you. I did not hear the amen well. Shout that amen like thunder. The first day, several years ago, I had the opportunity to have, if I say 10 naira, you might not get it. I had the opportunity to have, 10,000. I had the opportunity to have less than $50. I had the money, I put it in my coat. Because that time we don't wear suit, we wear coat. The difference between suit and coat is that coat, when you wear it, when you put money in the inner pocket, it gets to the lapel here. It does not have pocket because there are no linings inside. Can I teach here? I'm going somewhere. Somebody extravagant glory has come for you. I entered a passenger bus and I was sitting two people here and I was sitting at the middle. The vehicle was entering gallop everywhere and the two guys were just hitting me left and right. And especially the one by my right, he was just hitting where the $50 was. Hitting it. I look at him, I say, oh, excuse me, sir. Shift. He look at me and say, please allow me. And after some time, he will hit me again. I told myself, no, I'm not saved yet. I put my hand like this in the bus. I say, Father, I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. Nobody will steal my money. When we are still going and I discover that the two guys, I look at their eyes, they were not smiling. Then I said, no, I'm in the midst of armed robbers. Then I now told the driver, I want to calm down. Please, don't stop here. The driver said, there's no bus stop. I said, drop me here. It is safer I have my $50 in my pocket and trek home than to be in this bus and they rob me. I prophesy. I don't know your level of poverty, but today marks the end of that poverty. I did not hear the amen well. Shout that amen like thunder. When I gave my life to Christ, my father, who was I came from a chronic Islamic country. Thank God for your former president that declared this country a Christian country. May God bless him. May God bless him. Hear this. I am born from an Islamic background. My father disowned me for 3.5 years and said, for preaching Christ, you are finished. The night, I'm talking about extravagant glory. Whatever God say, your miracle will be, nobody can stop it. I will not forget. I was chased out of the house in the middle of the night. About after 12. I used to remember a pastor I know. I went to his door as a new convert that left Islam. I knocked at the door. I said, please, sir, I don't have where to lay my head. Help me. He looked at me and said, your father is very wicked. I can't allow you to enter here. I said, but I heard you preach about love 3 weeks ago, pastor. He said, I preach it, and that does not mean I must be the first one to show it to you. I left him injured as a new convert. Hear this. God is mighty. When I was going on the way, I said, God, these Christians are hypocrites. They don't practice what they preach. I'm going back to my father. Do you hear what the Holy Ghost told me? He said, son, Christianity is a personal race. Hear this. The faith of your pastor can't save you. The faith of your husband can't save you. Don't ever leave Jesus because of a man of God, because of a woman of God, because of anybody. Jesus is alive. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive. Hear this. He's not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Faithful is he that hath called. He's the same today, yesterday, and forever. Let me slow down with my message. What is going on? I left home. I was wandering in the middle of the night. How many of you are wandering in the middle of your night? Imagine if I have backslided that several years ago. Would you know me now? No. What are you going through now that look like there will be no glory? Touch your weeping may endure for the night. Your joy cometh in the morning. Who said you will not have glory? Who said so? Who is judging you? You cannot judge the content of the book by the cover of the book. I might not look beautiful, but my story is interesting. Am I talking to somebody here? I might look like nobody, but I am a some entity. I am a somebody. I am a somebody. I am a somebody. We are in the last days. the faith of your pastor. If I have decided to backslide because of my man of God, that time I won't be here. Pastors, let's stop fighting one another. Stop fighting one another. We are called to please Jesus. We are not called to fight one another. Whether you are for Apollos or you are for Paul, the Lord is the giver of all increase. Can I talk? Can I speak? Can I go forward? Can I communicate more? When I see pastors sending higher assassins to one another, it is barbaric, satanic, myopic, pinjomic, and microscopic. Can I talk here? Stop fighting one another. Stop criticizing one another. Generals don't fight one another. Generals defend one another. Let us stand behind one another. We are preaching one Jesus, the same today, yesterday, and forever. Can I talk? A man left you and say he will not marry you. That is not the end of the war. You are better. Extravagant glory is coming ahead of you. Who said without that man you cannot be better? It's not the owner of your future. Your future is in the hands of the Lord. Your future is in the hands of the Lord. Am I talking here? Is somebody hearing what God is saying here? Who said you can't make it? Who said? I remember that night. I was moving alone. I was crying like a baby. How many of you are moving alone? They have rejected you. There are pastors that other men of God have spoiled your name. Hear this. No matter how they spoil your name, if you are born for glory, you will shine. Am I prophesying? Ladies and gentlemen, no matter how dark the night is, when it is time for Brother Son to come out, Brother Son will come out and darkness will give way. Your time has come. The night will pass away. The night will pass away. The night will pass away. The way you are shouting that amen is looking for my trouble. Shout that amen like thunder. Thy kingdom is coming. It will come. Nobody can stop it. Brethren, Jesus is coming again. Jesus is coming again. Jesus is coming again. A Sango man can save you. An occultic power can save you. Witchcraft power can save you. But Jesus is alive. When he say yes, no man can say no. Wherefore God has given him a name that is highly exalted, that at the mentioning of the name of Jesus, every forces in Zambia shall bow. Every forces in Zambia shall bow. Every demon in Zambia shall bow. Every force out in Zambia shall bow. Occultic power in Zambia shall bow. Witches and wizards shall bow. Arrows of the enemy shall bow. Demonic power shall bow. Occultic prophet shall bow. Spell caster shall bow. Powers that kill president shall bow. Am I talking here? Kingdom come. You hear this? Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Everything that is in heaven is about to manifest in your life. Am I talking here? Let me begin to run up. I see breakthrough. I see breakthrough. Go to 1 Corinthians 2 9. He said, but as it is written, I had not seen. nor hear head. Neither have you entered the heart of a man the things which God is has prepared for me. Joshua Igila, put your name. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God has prepared for me, for me, for me, for me, for me, for me. Can I say this? Can I say this? Can I say this? If you don't have a car, the reason why you don't have a car is because your own car has not been manufactured. Am I talking here? Am I talking here? Am I talking here? Eyes have not seen. Nobody have seen what God has prepared. It has not come to their heart. You are too special. You are too special. They are trying to stop you, but they can't stop you. They are trying to kill you, but they can't kill you. Because eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it come to the heart of men what the Lord has prepared. Your time has come. Your season has come. Your season has come. Let Reuben live and not die. Anyone that say you will die, they will die your death. Anyone that say you will die, they will die your death. They will cry your cry. For the Bible say, for we know that all things working together for them that loveth God, that are called according to the purpose of God. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. When he lifts you up, no man can bring you down. When God is on your side, favor is on your side. When God is on your side, lifting is on your side. When God is on your side, glory is on your side. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a living God. He's the same today, yesterday, and forever. Lift up your leg and shout fire. Somebody say Ororo. Say Ororo. Hey! 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 Every arrow of the enemy catch fire. 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 Catch fire.